You know, we're really gonna have to do something about his indigestion.
After we finish the lesson, I'll give him some milk of magnesia.
Well, that ought to help.
Thank you, but there is nothing whatsoever wrong with my digestion. Now, if you are quite ready with my globe. Now, where were we? Oh, yes, of course. Now, the plural of... may I have your attention? The plural of octopus is octopi. Hippopotamus, hippopotami. Cacatus, cacati. Stimulus, stimuli. Radius, radii.
Applepus, apple pie?
And we can manage quite nicely, thank you, without the gratuitous flippancy.
Gratuitous, gratuiti?
That was rather cheeky. And now for geography. Don't fidget, dear. Paula, pay attention. Now, where are we? Please, don't fidget. We'll start with Istanbul. It's a nice, bright blue. Don't fidget, Paula.
Oh, can't we go to Africa this week, Mr. Robotham? I'm tired of China and Europe and all those dreary places.
Paula, your knowledge of Africa, I fear, is limited to a somewhat distressing affinity with its fauna. An affinity which I personally can only regard as alarming in the extreme. Now, one reason for my own intellectual equipoise lies in my constant and determined avoidance of all contact with the animals. This is a cardinal point of my philosophy, which I feel you might do very, very well to emulate.
You mean I should be like you, Mr. Robotham?
Well, example is the most rational form of education.
But the animals love me, Mr. Robotham. Well, come to think of it, they love you too.
Precisely why I will continue to regard them, I beg your pardon, with a sensible and proper suspicion and avoid all personal contact with them whatsoever. Whew, this heat. We must remember that in the animal, man is served for dinner.